o'clock at night and 12 midnight. When we locked down the station of 1.3, it's caused structural problems of such egregious injustice and inequality. Even the calling of the shutdown in 4 hours notice was a sign of panic from this prime minister, because he knows that this infrastructure in this country can't even deal with normality, forget about a pandemic.
Arundhati, I want to ask you more about that, about Modi's declaration of a lockdown with just 4 hours notice. He declared it at 8 p.m. and it went into effect at midnight on March 24th. But the first reported case of COVID-19 was on January 30th, so he had... It's unclear why he took 7 weeks to shut down of these migrants.
Hello, Reno Knight.
Can you tell us what they said about their situation?
Well, as soon as the lockdown was announced, mass transport was stopped. It was the last week of March. People had not been paid their salaries. People who live virtually from day to day. The landlords in these little cramped medieval tenements into which, you know, 5 and 10 people are squashed into a room said that they wanted their rent on time. So people just had to leave. And it was a surreal sight, you know, while there was no traffic on the streets. But suddenly, you know, the structural inequality and the horror, the shame of how our societies live made themselves manifest, you know. And I just realized that these people have started walking for hundreds of kilometers to their villages. And I went out because I felt like the tectonic plates were shifting, you know, it was crazy. So I went to the border between Delhi and Uttar Pradesh, where I walked with many of them. And I spoke to many of them, including Muslims who have just survived this horrific kind of...
Sorry about the metal clanging. That's why Target stands back there.
It didn't turn out that way because people were so prepared that they fought back. But having...
I hung out with the high rollers.
Looks like a good place.
Hey, bud.
What's up, brother?
With these tactical pro pants, can you throw magazines in them?
Yeah. That's probably my least favorite jacket, though. I would get it.
Really?
I'll see why. So. That's an awesome pant, honestly, when it was made, but we kind of made some advances since then. So, this Tap Life Pro, right? It's kind of cool because it's a ripstop.
Yeah, that's fucking important.
But it's a really big, baggy fitting pant because there's no stretch in the jacket.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? So that's kind of my first issue. The next one is pocket layout. So this magazine pocket right here looks exactly like it is a magazine pocket. Like, you just, it screams out, hey, look at me, I'm carrying that.
I thought it was for leather, man.
Even some of the other tactical pants don't look as tactical, I guess, and so that kind of helps. You do have a little bit of a corner here to probably clip a magazine pocket, but it's only over this edge right here.
On the left side?
It's on both.
Oh, okay.
Now with that, the pocket layout, especially since this is an external pocket, and then when you look at these back pockets, this is at such a dramatic angle to get like a normal pocket would be right here, right? So to get a usable depth, it's right here. So now anything in these back pockets, way down here. So what did this pocket and my other pocket do? Pushed your cargo pocket way down here.
Okay.
So the pocket layout is kind of funky. It's a throwback to when we made rock climbing pants, and it makes a lot of sense for that. It doesn't make a lot of sense for day to day. Now, it's awesome that the waistband stretches, right?
Except for love.
This kind of lap, like this kind of stretch right here. Like if you're over the age of 3 and under 83, I don't really see this as being necessary. Let me show you why. So like this here, it's not quite as big and baggy, but you get the same range of motion because of the stretch of the material. So you know how, say you go to crouch down or grab something, you have to be like this with your pants a lot of times so they don't bind up on your knee. These stretch, doesn't do that, man. It just stretches around your knee. You don't have that issue, okay? That front pocket here is internal on both sides. It'll fit the arm bands.
No shit.
It will.
Does this stretch as well?
No, not really, but it fits the arm bands.
Okay.
Cordura on the pockets, except for it's kind of, well, I don't have a knife for that, that's weird. It protects the clip for the entire length of the clip.
Okay.
Even if it's a really long clip and it would have went over here, well, it's going to go right under there, so it doesn't affect the way that pocket opens.
Nice.
Okay. More of your kind of standard tactical pocket with the flap there, so it's internal. So what happens there? Pocket. Oh, hey, I can reach both of them. Then lastly, you actually have more stretch and it's more comfortable. So that's kind of the differences on those two, which is why I prefer the Strike a lot. The next one, yeah, the next one that kind of compares is going to be the Icon. So what I like about the Icon, it's a lot lighter weight material, so it's a good summer pant. You still have that stretch there.
That is fucking lighter, noticeably, actually.
The big difference is no double knee here. It's an articulated knee instead. And then the stretch on the waistband is a little different.
Okay, so it's not like a belt.
Right.
That's awesome.
You have these two stretchable panels on your pockets. And then these are cut a little bit larger. It makes it a little bit easier to put an electric phone in there. The other thing with this is these are a little bit of a tapered leg. They still fit over boots, but they're labeled as a slim. Our slim isn't like skinny jeans, which is what a lot of people think when you say that. So, matter of fact, if you look at, although that one's kind of bunched up and messed up, but this is the same pant over boots. You know what I mean?
It fits a lot better.
So, yeah, it's not big, baggy, and flowy looking. You don't have a lot of, like, this where it kind of sits on each other, got all these extra wrinkles and stuff. It's just a more fitted pant. If you have big calves, those are, could be an issue, though.
No, I have normal human calves.
Welcome to 5'11". And then the other one that's... So the Strike and the Apex are my favorites. It just depends on what you're using them for.
Basically, spelunking something that could take a fucking beating. And I'm trying to have one pair of training gear.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Then I would probably do the Strikes.
I'm balling on a fucking budget, but I don't want shit that'll last.
Well, I mean, if you buy T-Pants, you're going to end up buying 8 of them, or you buy one pair of these ones.
That's true.
So, either the Strike or the Icon.
These are the Icon, these are the Strikes.
Mm-hmm.
got this in gray.
What size?
38, 30. They give a little bit, so I'm planning on. Damn, I like this color.
I'm able to fit it in gray.
I'm glad about the good times.